I was diagnosed, and about a year later is when I started recognizing that things didn't feel so good. I started emotionally, I started just having a really rough time. I never wanted to see anybody. I was crying at the drop of a hat. I had anxiety attacks daily. It was different than how I had felt 6 months ago. It was situational depression. So had I not had this diagnosis, this terminal diagnosis, I wouldn't have had the depression and anxiety. It was based on my diagnosis, but I just felt different. I was hopeless. I was helpless. I had no motivation. I just felt terrible. And I was about 3 months in or so, and I thought, there's something not good here. Like, this isn't, we were in about November, and I absolutely love Christmas. And it was something I was looking forward to, but I didn't have that same magic in me. And so in January of 2017, I finally sought help and went and saw a psychiatrist and explained how I was feeling. And she said, you do have depression and you do have anxiety. And she was willing to put me on medication, but my primary focus was cognitive behavioral therapy, which was an absolute game changer. So I worked really hard with changing the way I thought and changing my perspective on things. And it's not to say that I came out of it going, oh, I'm fine and everything's great and everything's cheery. But I didn't have that same helplessness, and I was able to go and visit family, and I felt like myself again after quite a while. But it took a lot of work, and that's why, for me, I'm quite an advocate for not one without the other. I would never suggest just, yep, here's a prescription, see in 6 months, hope you feel better. And also, if somebody is very against medication, just doing cognitive behavioral therapy. For me, it was a hand-in-hand situation. And about a year later, I came off of it, and that was more than 6 months ago, and I'm glad to say I'm on the other side of it, but it takes a lot of work. And apparently, it is quite common that it is about the year mark, which I found out after the diagnosis. I think just kind of the dust is settling. If you're in treatment, in my case, I was stable, so things had kind of calmed down a little bit. I wasn't at the hospital quite as much, and I think I just kind of had time to think, oh, this is actually happening. Like, this isn't just scan results and doctors like, these aren't just words. This is actually growing in your body, and you're not going to see whatever the magic number is, 40 years old, 35 years old. And so I think for me, it was kind of that realization in that time to kind of decompress and think, wow, this is a real, at 31 years old, you might not see your first wedding anniversary. And I am just so grateful that I did reach out for help, because it was the amount of crying that I would do and the amount of just the emotion and the despair. I think that's a good way of saying it. Just the absolute despair was horrible. It was a horrible feeling on top of having terminal cancer.